Hello students, today we have got history lecture and we'll do the second chapter. In your textbook, come to your page number 7, lesson number 2, and the name of the lesson is Historiography, Indian Tradition. Last time we seen what you mean by historiography. It means the study of the writing of history and of written histories. Today we'll see the tradition. Now what you mean by tradition? Tradition means it is a transmission of customs or beliefs from generation to generation. Now just a small introduction, it is not there in your textbook, please pay attention now. Traditions in Indian historiography and various ideological frameworks adopted by Indian history are discussed in this chapter. So we are going to discuss the Indian historiography is being discussed in this chapter. Tradition of Indian historiography can be studied by classifying into 3 periods. Which are the 3 periods? Ancient periods. What ancient periods deals with? Inscriptions on rocks and stone pillars, means written on rocks and stone pillars. Medieval period, influenced by Persian style of writing by Mughals and Bakaras. Okay, Bakaras. So what medieval period consists? It consists the Persian style of writing by the Mughals and the modern period that is written by the British about India. So all these 3 periods we are going to discuss. Now first thing, traditional of Indian historiography. We learned about the Western tradition of historiography in the last lesson. So in the last lesson, we seen the contribution of Western thinkers. In this lesson, we will know about the tradition of Indian historiography. So we are going to study in this chapter the tradition of Indian history. And you know what you mean by tradition. It is a transmission of customs or beliefs from one generation to another generation. Now, historiography in the ancient period. Now, you know what you mean by ancient period. Things which were written on rocks or on the stone pillars. In the ancient period in India, memories of great deeds of ancestors. Ancestors means who? Our forefathers. And mythological. Mythology means what? It's a study and interpretation of sacred tales or fables, means we study about, for example, studying something from Ramayana or Mahabharata. And lore means what? Passed from person to person by word or mouth. Also, memories of social transactions were preserved with the help of oral recitals. Now, recitals means what? Performance of a program of music by a solo singer or by a group of singers, that is by mouth. The inscriptions on the Harappan seal and other artifacts confirm that Indians had mastered the art of writing as early as the 3rd millennium BCE or perhaps before that. However, the Harappan script is not yet successfully deciphered. Deciphered means what? It is not been discovered. What has been written? What things were found during the Harappan civilization? The earliest known written documents of historical natural found in India are in the form of inscriptions. They are dated to the 3rd century BCE, that is Emperor Ashok Maurya's time. Its edicts are inscribed on natural rocks and stone pillars, means what? Whatever things are written on natural rocks and it's written on the stone pillars. From the 1st century CE, inscription began to occur on coins. Okay, something was written on the coins. Then metal images, metal, you know, things which are made from iron or copper, and sculpture, and also on copper plates. They provide important historical information. We get to know about the dates of various king dynasty. Dynasty means what? Rulers of a country. And genealogies. Genealogies territorial extent and administration of various empires and kingdoms are also important political events. Social organization, climate, famines, etc. of the respective times. So all this we studied during the ancient period, that is your social organization, climate, famines of respective times. The ancient Indian literature, including the epics, Ramayana and Mahabharata, Puranas, Jain and Buddhist texts, these are some of the holy books. Historical accounts by Indian authors and also travelogue by foreign travelers. Travelogue means what? These foreign travelers had the habit of maintaining a diary and writing in the diary, that is called travelogues, are important source of history. So all these are what? Important sources, like your holy books, Ramayana, Mahabharatas, Puranas, Jain and Buddhist texts, travelogue. These are what? These are some of the sources of history. Writings of biographies. Now what do you mean by biographies? An account of someone's life written by someone. That's called your biography. Of king and dynastic. Dynastic means rulers. Histories marks an important step in the Indian historiography. Harish Charitya, written in 7th century CE by Banu Bhatta, is King Harsha's biography. So this King Harsha's biography has also been written. It portrays, it tells us a realistic picture of the social, economic, political, religious and cultural life during the king's time. So in this book, it tells the life of the kings. Now, historiography in the medieval period. Now, what do you mean by medieval? Relating to something to middle age. The style of writing, Rajat Tarangini, The History of Kashmir by Kalana in the 12th century CE, is quite close to the concept of modern historiography. Kalana himself says that he wrote his text after critical examining. So he said, after going through a proper study, he writes various things. Various sources like inscription, coins, remains of ancient monuments, dynastic records and local traditions. So Kalana was of the opinion that after making a detailed study, what is written on coins, then on ancient monuments, rulers and local tradition, he starts writing. In the medieval India, the historians in the court of Muslim rulers were influenced by Arabic and Persian historiography. Among them, Ziauddin Barani holds an important place. So this, a Muslim ruler, Ziauddin, he also holds an important place. In Tariq-e-Firoz-Shahiya book written by him, he has stated the purpose of historiography. So Ziauddin, in his book, he has given what are the aims and objectives of historiography. According to him, the historian's duty is not limited only to the recordings of the ruler's valor. Valor means what? His great courage. A historian's duty is not limited to great courage and policies of welfare, but he should also write about the ruler's failings and incorrect policy. So he should not write only what he has done, what great courageous work he has done, but why he was a failings in incorrect policies. Barani further says that the historian should also take into consideration the impact of the teachings of the wise, the learned and the saints on the cultural life of the people. So a historian should also discuss the teachings of the saint and all the cultural life of the people. Thus, Barani expanded the scope of historiography. Expanded means what? He tried to spread the scope of historiography. For the historians in the Mughal court, praising the emperor and exhibition of loyalty became more important. The custom of adding suitable poetic quotes, you know, adding a poetic some quotations and beautiful pictures was also introduced. Babur, the founder of the Mughal Empire, wrote an autobiography entitled Tuzak-i-Babri. It contains the description of the battles fought by him. So, in this book written by Babur, he tells about the description of the battles fought by him. Babur also recorded his minute means what? All small observation of various regions and cities traveled by him, including the local economy. Economy means what? What was the business during this Mughal Empire? Custom and flora, trying to study the various geographical things, the climate and everything. Abul Fazl's Akbar-nama. Okay, so Abul Fazl written a book and the name of the book was Akbar-nama. Is very important from the viewpoint of critical historiography. His method of collecting authentic means what? Origin, historical documents and their scrutiny. Scrutiny means what? Critical observation. Scrutiny is looked upon as devoid. Devoid means free from bias. Bias means against an idea and hence realistic. So they do a critical observation and they see it's from free from any ideas and hence they come out with a real writing of the person. Bakhar is an important type of historical documents of medieval time. It contains eulogies. Now eulogies means what? Speech or pieces of writing that praises someone. Of the heroes and stories of historical events, battle, lives of a great man. Now again I'll explain. Bakhar is an important type of historical document of medieval time. It contains eulogies of the heroes and stories of historical events, battles, lives of great men. Marathi Bakhars are of various types. Sabhasat Bakhar was written by Krishnaji Anand Sabhasat during the period of Chhatrapati Rajaram Maharaj. It is an important Bakhar for getting information about the rule of Chhatrapati Shivaji Maharaj. So this Marathi Bakhar giving us information about the rule of Chhatrapati Shivaji Maharaj. Then Bahu Saibanchi Bakhar describes the Battle of Panipat. Now you know this Battle of Panipat. Another Bakhar entitled Panipatachi Bakhar is also about the same event. Holkaranchi Kaya Fiat provide information about the Holkar and the contribution of the Maratha ruler. So all these things are written in a one type of historical document and that is called your Bakhar. Bakhar can be divided into various types such as biographies of kings, dynastic history, that is ruler's history, description of events, history of a sect. Sect means a belonging to different religious group. Autobiographies regarding grievances based on mythologies and state administration by a king. Now, next thing, historiography in the modern period. You know what you mean by modern period, written by British about India. Now, in the 20th century, the Indian archaeological exploration and research started under the British rule. You know what you mean by archaeological, digging a particular place and trying to remove the things from there and doing a detailed study. A number of ancient sites were excavated under the supervision of Sir Alexander Cunningham, the first director general of the archaeological survey. So he was the first director general, who? Sir Alexander Cunningham. He chose mainly the sites mentioned in the Buddhist texts for the purpose. Harappan civilization was discovered during the tenure. Tenure means what? During his period. Period of Sir John Marshall. Because of this discovery, the antiquity of the Indian history could be traced to 3rd millennium BCE or even earlier. Many British officers in India wrote about Indian history. So many Britishers wrote about Indian history. Their writing displays strong influence of the colonial policies of the British. So this colonial, okay, about the British policy, it has been described. 3 volumes of the History of British India written by James Mill were published in 1817. This was the first book of Indian history written by British historian. Which book? The History of British Indian, written by James Mill. It clearly reflects an absence of objective perspective and prejudice about various aspects of Indian culture. The History of India, written by Mountstuart Elphinstone, governor of Bombay, now Mumbai. So during those days, he was a governor of Bombay, and now we call Bombay as Mumbai, was published in 1841. The period of Maratha Empire is very important in the Indian history. Grant Duff's name stands out among the British officers who wrote about Maratha history. He wrote the book entitled A History of Marathas. Who? Grant Duff. Written a book, The History of Marathas. This book is published in 3 volumes. The Grant Duff writing also shows the British inclination of condemning Indian culture and history. So the books tells us about the Indian culture and history. Similar tendency it witnessed in colonials. Todd's writing about Rajasthan history. The 2 volumes written by William Wilson Hunter on Indian history show somewhat impartial treatment of the subject. Nilkant Janardhan Kirtane and Vishwanath Kashinath Rajwade were 2 Indian historians who took upon the task of exposing the limitation of Grant Duff writing. So these 2 Indian historians, they brought the limitation of this person, that is Grant Duff writing. So students, today we'll discuss till here. In the next history class, we will discuss from page number 10. Hope so you have understood tradition of Indian history. Thank you.